At the end of 2020, there are estimated to be around 1.4 billion cars in use worldwide. And these numbers are increasing rapidly, especially in China, India, and other newly industrialized countries. So it's safe to say that cars are one of the important inventions in human history. Cars we drive today were never the same in early days. They have evolved over time. The car we drive today is a result of decades of experiments and inventions. Hello everyone, I am Varun, and in this episode 1 of the series, we are looking at the experiments and inventions performed in the past which have led us to the car we drive today. The first car was invented somewhere around 1672. The car was developed by Ferdinand Verbenist and was working on steam power. Car was unable to run, and that's why many considered it as a failure. But it marked the base for future development of steam powered car. The first full-scale self-propelled mechanical car was invented by Nicolas Joseph Cugnot in 1769. It was a steam powered tricycle. Cugnot developed two steam tricycles, one of which is preserved in French National Conservatory of Arts and Craft. The car was able to drive but was impractical as it needed a sufficient steam pressure for longer duration of time. In 1807, Knife Brother created which is considered as the world's first internal combustion engine. But they chose to install it on boat instead. Coincidentally, the same year in 1807, Isaac de Rivaz designed and developed his own car working on de Rivaz internal combustion engine. Although neither of these designs were successful. It was in 1879 the first internal combustion engine was patented after Carl Benz, who is acknowledged as the inventor of modern car. His first motor wagon, which was built in 1885, was awarded the patent for its invention in 1886. On August 1888, Bertha Benz, the wife of Carl Benz, undertook the first road trip by car to prove the roadworthiness of her husband's invention. In the coming times, Carl Benz, under his company name as Benz and Cie, sold 25 Benz vehicles from 1888 to 1893. These vehicles were powered with 4-stroke engine of his own design. In 1896, Carl Benz designed and patented his first internal combustion flat engine called as boxer motor. In old days, Benz and Cie sold 572 units up till 1899. Another company known as Daimler Motor and Gesellschaft was founded in 1890 by Daimler and Maybach. They sold their first car in 1892 under the brand name of Daimler. Up till 1895, Daimler have sold around 30 vehicles. These two companies revolutionized the use of petrol-based internal combustion engine cars. In 1892, German engineer Rudolf Diesel was granted a patent for his combustion engine. He went on to build his first diesel engine in 1897. The diesel engine we use today has evolved over his first design. The first working car powered by electricity was developed by the French inventor Gustave in 1881. It marked the beginning of use of electricity for running cars. Beginning of 19th century marked the end of initial phase of experiments and inventions of different types of cars and engines. After that, mass production of cars started. Large-scale production line manufacturing of affordable cars was started by Ransom Old in 1901 at his Oldsmobile factory in Michigan. Concept of assembly line style of mass production was expanded by Henry Ford beginning in 1913 with the first moving assembly line for cars at Highland Park Ford plant. Mass production of cars enable common people to afford car, thus beginning the phase of commonization of cars. During 18th century, cars running on various power sources like steam, electricity and gasoline were experimented. Cars running on steam failed as these cars needed steam to be maintained at high pressure for a long time. While on the other hand, due to limitations of storage batteries, cars running on electric power failed too. As these two options were not viable, gasoline and diesel were the only alternatives. The gasoline and diesel powered cars require a combustion engine. As external combustion engines were impractical, internal combustion engines were used in 99% of cars. In the beginning of 19th century, peoples in developed nations started becoming more curious about cars. Thus, the demand increased. To keep up with such high demand, mass production of internal combustion engine cars started. Hello everyone, I am Varun, and in this episode 2 of the series, we are looking at the monopoly of IC engine cars in 19th century. In 1901, Ransom Old started large-scale production, line manufacturing of affordable car at his Oldsmobile factory in Michigan. This idea was more expanded by Henry Ford in 1913. He developed the world's first moving assembly line for cars at Highland Park Ford plant. This resulted in Ford assembling cars in 15-minute interval, which was much faster than the previous method, increasing productivity. The success of Ford in automotive industry was dominating, and it quickly spread worldwide. Ford expanded in France, Britain, Denmark, Germany before the end of 1925. Soon many companies followed Ford and established their own assembly line production method. Not because they want to, but because they have to. By 1930, around 250 companies who didn't adopt such production method disappeared. Development of automobile technology was rapid due to hundreds of small manufacturers competing to gain world's attention in 1920s. In this period, development of electric ignition and self-starter for quick engine start, suspension for comfort, and four-wheel brake for rapid stopping were done. In 1920, General Motors came up with General Motors Companion Make program. It was done so that buyers could move up as fortune improves. It was introduced to bridge up the pricing and design gaps in General Motors brand. The GM product ladder started from price-leading Chevrolet to more luxurious Cadillac. Reflecting to the rapid pace of change, car manufacturers started adopting the policy of interchangeability. Interchangeability basically means exchanging part for better productivity. For example, in 1930, cars sold by Cadillac used cheaper mechanical parts made by Oldsmobile. This resulted in reduction of cost of manufacturing and increase in profits. In America, during the Great Depression of 1940, hundreds of American car manufacturers suffered and eventually was shut down. By 1940, only 17 American cars manufacturers survived. In Japan, car production was limited before World War II. Most of them were producing cars by partnering with European companies like Isuzu with Holsle and Mitsubishi with Fiat. Companies like Toyota, Nissan, Suzuki, Mazda, and Honda shifted from non-automobile business to automobile business during 1950s. Toyota, which once was a loom company, shifted into automobile manufacturing and eventually led on to become the largest automobile manufacturer in the world. After 1950, automobile sector was booming and cars were getting produced at a very large scale. But increase in the number of cars working on gasoline and diesel were causing a great environmental damage. In response to this, automobile emission norms were established. The first automobile emission standard were enacted by United States in 1963. It was due to the Los Angeles smog problem. Japan, Canada, and several European nations followed soon. After 1980, automobile sector was continuously hindered by environmental issues due to pollutant emitted by cars. Due to such environmental issues and increase in the prices of gasoline and diesel, car manufacturers were looking for alternative power source. at the beginning of 20th century, the development of high storage capacity batteries resulted in the rise of electric cars. IC engines are still the major power source for cars, but due to the shift of many companies to electric car manufacturing and the rise of new electric-only car manufacturers like Tesla, made it sure that the monopoly of IC engine cars is soon to end. The first practical electric car was produced in 1880s. Electric cars were popular in late 19th century and early 20th century. But due to advances in internal combustion engines, quicker refueling time, and mass production of cheaper petrol and diesel vehicles enable IC engine cars to become more popular during most of 20th century. It was then in 1980s when electric cars were again reconsidered. Due to high gasoline and diesel prices, environmental pollution and development of high capacity batteries led to the development of modern electric road vehicles. Hello everyone, I am Varun, and in this episode 3 of the series, we are going to look at evolution and rise of electric cars over the years. The first practical car were produced in 1880s. On November 1881, Gustav Trow presented an electric car at Auto Show in Paris. In 1884, over 20 years before Ford Model T, Thomas Parker built a practical production electric car in Wolverhampton using his own specially designed high-capacity rechargeable batteries. Although the only documentation of the car is a photograph from 1895. In 1888, German inventor Andreas Flocken designed and developed his Flocken Electrowagon, which is regarded as the first real electric car. Electric cars were among the preferred method for automobile propulsion in late 19th and early 20th century, as they provided a level of comfort and ease of operation that would not be achieved by gasoline cars at that time. The electric vehicle stock peaked at approximately 30,000 vehicles at the time of 20th century. In 1897, electric cars found their first commercial use as a taxi in Britain and the US. At the end of 19th century, electric vehicle manufacturers in US like Anthony Electric, Bakers, Columbia, Anderson, Detroit Electric, and others came into prominence. During the early 20th century, electric cars were still considered as one of the options for automobile propulsion. They do have their advantages as they have less noise and did not require any gear change. But due to the problem of travel range and large time required for refueling, resulted in the decline of electric cars in 20th century. The emergence of metal oxide semiconductor technology led further development of modern electric road cars. But it was then in 1980 when lithium ion battery were invented by John Goodenough, Rashid Yazami and Akira Yoshino, which enabled the development of electric cars capable of long-distance travel. In early 1990s, California Air Resources Board began a push for more efficient and lower-emission vehicles. In response, automakers developed electric models including Chrysler TE-Van, Ford Ranger EV pickup truck, GM EV1, and many more. California electric automaker Tesla Motors began development in 2004. They developed Tesla Roadster, which was first delivered to customer in 2008. The Roadster was the first highway-legal all-electric car to use lithium-ion battery cells and the first production car to travel more than 320 km per charge. Mitsubishi IMI EV, launched in 2009 in Japan, was the first highway-legal series production electric car. It was the first electric car to sell more than 10,000 units, including the model batch in Europe as Citroën C0 and Peugeot Ion. Nissan Leaf, launched in 2010, surpassed Mitsubishi car to become all-time best-selling all-electric car. Due to more aggressive automobile emission norms for IC engines and on the other hand, ease regulation for electric cars are causing automobile manufacturers to shift to electric car manufacturing. The removal of engine and presence of electric batteries in electric car have enabled more advancement. Many electric cars now come up with its own self-driving features like Tesla Autopilot. This have enabled automobile manufacturers to manufacture autonomous vehicles. The use of autonomous features will increase the safety of passengers. Safety being the priority of automobile industry right now, many automobile manufacturers are shifting towards self-driving cars. So it's safe to say now, the days of car driving on its own are soon to come. Humans have been dreaming for cars driving on its own from a long time. As of today, more than 40 companies are actively investing in autonomous vehicle technology, including heavyweights like Ford, Tesla, BMW and Mercedes-Benz. Autonomous vehicles are not a fantasy anymore, and we are going to see fully autonomous vehicles running on road really soon. Hello everyone, I am Varun, and in this episode 4 of the series, we are going to look at development of autonomous vehicle over the years and shift of automobile industry towards self-driving cars. Experiments have been conducted on automatic driving systems since at least 1920s, whereas trial began in 1950. In 1925, Houdini Radio Control demonstrated radio-controlled American Wonder on New York City streets, traveling up the Broadway and down Fifth Avenue. The car was equipped with transmitting antenna and was operated by a person in another car. The first semi-automated car was developed in 1977 by Japan Tsukuba Mechanical Engineering Laboratory, which requires specially marked streets that were interpreted by two cameras on vehicle and an analog computer. The vehicle reached speeds up to 30 km per hour with the support of an elevated rail. In the 1980s, vision-guided Mercedes-Benz robotic van, designed by Ernest Dieckmann and his team in Munich, achieved a speed of 63 km an hour on street without traffic. In the same decade, the Defense Advanced Research Project Agency, or DARPA, funded autonomous land-driven vehicle project in United States. The ALV project achieved the first road-following demonstration that uses LiDAR, computer vision, and autonomous robotic control to direct the robotic vehicle at the speed of up to 31 km per hour. In May of 1998, Toyota becomes the first to introduce adaptive cruise control system on production vehicle, which was sold in Japan. In 21st century, many automotive manufacturers, including General Motors, Ford, Mercedes-Benz, Volkswagen, Audi, Nissan, Toyota, BMW and Volvo are in process of testing driverless car systems. In May of 2014, Google announced plans to unveil 100 autonomous car prototypes built from scratch inside Google's secret X Lab. In the same year, Tesla Motors announced its first version of Autopilot. Model S cars equipped with this system are capable of lane control with autonomous steering, braking and speed limit adjustments. It was based on signals image recognition. The system also provides autonomous parking and is able to receive software updates to improve skill over time. In 2015, Volvo Cars announced its plan to lease 100 XC90 SUVs, which are fitted with DriveMe Level 3 automation technology. In the same year, the US states of Nevada, Florida, California, Virginia, and Michigan, together with Washington DC, allowed testing of automatic cars on public road. In November 2017, Waymo announced that it is going to test driverless car without a safety driver in driver position. In October 2018, Waymo announced that it have traveled for over 16 million kilometers in autonomous mode. In 2014, Society of Automobile Engineers, which is an automotive standardization body, classified autonomy in 6 levels, ranging from fully manual to fully automated system. In level 0, autonomous system issues warning and momentarily intervenes, but has no sustained vehicle control. In level 1 autonomous system, the driver and automated system share control of vehicle, like adaptive cruise control and parking assist. In level 2 automated system, the automated system takes full control like acceleration, braking and steering. Driver must monitor the driving and be prepared to intervene immediately at any time if automated system fails to respond properly. In level 3 automated system, the driver can safely turn their attention away from driving task like texting or watching a movie. In level 4 automated system, no driver attention is required, like the driver may safely go to sleep or leave the driver's seat. However, self-driving is supported only in limited spatial areas or under special circumstances. In level 5 automated system, no human intervention is required. The vehicle is fully capable of taking you from starting point to destination without any need. It's fun to ponder a future filled with self-driving cars. A world with breezy commutes where autonomous vehicles have made a deadly crashes a thing of past. But how far off is that future? In 2016, Google suggested that this driverless utopia may actually be much farther away than many people realize. And there are many challenges to overcome, one of which is safety. Safety is a major point for developing autonomous cars. But for now, safety is a concern rather than an advantage. In 2016, the failure of Tesla Model S Autopilot caused the fatal incident in China, which led to the death of a driver. Again in 2017, one pedestrian was killed due to failure of autonomous system in Uber test vehicle. Another major challenge is to produce real-time maps. For now, Google seems to be the farthest along with that technology. Google's self-driving car work by relying on combination of detailed pre-made maps as well as sensors that see obstacles on the road in real time. In this system, one of the hardest aspects is to preload map, which requires employer first manually drive the vehicle all over the street and build a rich detailed 3D map of the area using rotating LiDAR camera on the car roof. Another hurdle to full autonomy is the fact that driving is an intensely social process that frequently involved intricate interaction with other drivers, cyclists and pedestrians. In many of such situations, humans rely on generalized intelligence and common sense that autonomous vehicles still very much lack. Other challenges ahead of development of autonomous vehicles are weather conditions, cyber security, time needed to turn over the existing stock of vehicles from non-automated to automated, concern about safety and implementation of legal framework. Considering so much challenges, is fully autonomous car a dream? I don't think so. Rise of electric cars and autonomous vehicles are indicator of revolution going on in automobile industry. With the rise of technologies like Internet of Things, robotics, artificial intelligence and machine learning, automobile industry have seen significant changes in last few decades. The utopian image of future with cars running on eco-friendly fuels and driving on its own is not far away now. Hello everyone, I am Varun and in this episode 5 of the series, we are going to look at the future of automobile industry. Four major trends known as CASE, which stands for Connected, Autonomous, Shared and Electric, are shaping the future of automobile industry. One of the major trends shaping the future of automobile industry is internet connectivity. Today's car can accomplish many tasks like suggesting alternative routes, traffic holds up, and can also remotely lock and unlock the car. In the near future, connectivity would expand further beyond. The cars would be able to communicate with each other by connecting with lasers, cameras, and radars. This car will be able to create 3D map of surrounding. This eventually led us to the second trend, that is autonomous driving. Let's face it, we are human and that's why we are prone to make mistakes. That is why many manufacturers are manufacturing autonomous cars. Today, this technology is in baby stage. But as this technology will evolve, we will see more and more autonomous cars on street. Technology like 3D LiDAR along with many advancements will surely enable us to make a level 4, level 5 autonomous car in future. The best thing about autonomous vehicle is service on demand. Many shared car service like Uber have already sprung up and are on the rise. In future, this service provider will own the fleets which would be hired by the person as per their needs. Electric cars are the future. Presently, they are holding their grip and challenging ICE engine cars, but it is sure that the future belongs to electric cars. With these vehicles, there is no problem of emissions. Even today, the car manufacturers like Tesla, Rivian, Ford are developing cars which have range more than 500 miles. But the invention of more powerful battery and growing number of charging stations, the range anxiety today will be vanished in future. Automobile manufacturers are also looking for alternative fuel resource other than electricity. Many manufacturers like Toyota are testing their vehicles with alternative fuels like hydrogen, propane, ethanol, solar energy, dimethyl ether fuel, ammonia and many more. In future, hydrogen is second in line to electricity as the major power source for cars. Hydrogen car uses hydrogen in one of two methods, one of which being combustion and another being fuel cell conversion. In combustion method, the hydrogen is burnt in engine in fundamentally the same method as traditional gasoline car. While in fuel cell conversion method, hydrogen is turned into electricity through fuel cells, which then powers electric motors. Either of these methods produce only one byproduct, that is water, which is harmless. For cars which are already rolled out on the street, making them electric is a difficult task. For such cars, dimethylene ether is a promising fuel. Dimethylene ether retains the highest C10 number with slight modification. The burning of dimethylene ethyl in diesel and petrol engine cars will produce more output and will reduce the emission of particulate matter, carbon dioxide and nitrogen oxide by a long way. Artificial intelligence and machine learning have an important role in the future of automotive industry. Predictive capabilities are becoming more prevalent in cars, which are personalizing the driving experience. Many manufacturers are using algorithms to automate the setting of vehicle, including cars' infotainment. Predictive vehicle technology can also be used in the form of sensors within the car that inform the owner whether or not the vehicle needs service from the mechanic. This will reduce the safety hazard linked with malfunctioning of cars. Involvement of big data and artificial intelligence have an essential role in customization of vehicles. Today, due to technologies like parking assistance and lane change, cars are only assisting drivers. But we are not far away from the future, where car will be able to communicate with each other and drive on its own. I am looking forward for such future. Are you?